Hey, good afternoon. Happy Father's Day to all of you who are fathers here in the U.S. Happy Father's Day to everybody, even if you're not in the U.S. Today I'm going to make carrot dogs for you. I'm Dr. Robin. I'm the co-founder of the Whole Food Muscle Club, and I am the co-author of the book, How to Feed a Human the Whole Food Muscle Way. If you've seen me cook before, you know that I tend to just kind of throw things together and pray that it turns out. I have looked at different recipes, looked at different ways of making carrot dogs. I've made them once or twice myself before, and so I thought I would go ahead and make a version of them for you today. What I've already done is I have already cooked the carrots. So I took some carrots, I cut them down, and you can see here I have the little pieces from cutting them down in my food processor. I'm going to make carrot ginger dressing out of the pieces. That recipe is in the Whole Food Muscle Club, so you can just go to wholefoodmuscle.com and sign on to your account. And then if you search carrot ginger dressing, there's a video of me making it and the recipe's in there. So I have a dozen. You don't have to make this many, it's just how many I made. The goal is to try and make the carrots roughly the same size, consistency across the length. And then you cook them, boil them for about 8 minutes until they're fork tender, but not until they're falling apart. The biggest challenge for me, and it happened again this time for me, is that because the end, I don't get them as consistent, so this end is cooked really nicely, but this end is a little bit too soft, so it's a little, but you know what, it's fine. They crumble a little bit, but it's fine. If you undercook them, you will end up with carrot dogs that taste like carrots. If you overcook them, they get mushy. So you kind of have to find that sweet spot where they're fork tender, but not falling apart. And once you do that, there's a couple of different ways once you have the marinade made that you can marinate them. I typically just put them in my 9x13 pan and cover it and put it in the fridge. You can also put them in a Ziploc bag as long as you're confident that it won't leak. That's an option too. But any way that you can just put them in marinade, the takeout trays from eating vegetable sushi work as well, as if you aren't going to make a whole bunch of them. So let's get to it. First thing you're going to need is some vegetable broth. You can use low sodium, you can use regular, whatever kind of makes you happy. I'm going to probably do about a cup and a half, but if a cup and a half is fine. So we'll just pour some of that in here. Doesn't have to be exact. There we go. That's good. All right. Then you're going to want some apple cider vinegar, probably about a quarter of a cup to a third of a cup of apple cider vinegar. Oh, and you know what? This is brand new. I hope it doesn't. Oh, good. It doesn't have a seal in the bottom on the inside. So we'll put a, say, quarter of a cup or so of that. And when you get done with this, a lot of recipes tell you to throw the marinade away. Don't throw the marinade away. You can make nacho cheese sauce with it. That turns out so good with this as part of the liquid, the water in it. That recipe also is on the Whole Food Muscle Club. So don't throw your marinade away. It makes amazing nacho cheese sauce. Then it says 2 tablespoons of soy sauce, so I'm just gonna, that much soy sauce in there. Then some maple syrup. Oh, you know what? This one's brand new too. And this one I know I can't open without a knife. Let me get a knife. Hold on. Hold that thought. I gotta walk over here. Here we go. They have this has the little thing that you're supposed to be able to open it. It doesn't actually work. I don't even know why they bothered to put it on there, because you can't actually use it. All right, so we're gonna have 2-ish tablespoons of maple syrup. So we'll just put some of that in there. That's probably good enough. All right, now, some recipes call for smoked paprika. You know, if you watch me, that I personally haven't found smoked paprika to be that much more flavorful than regular paprika, and it's much more expensive. So I just use regular, especially if I'm mixing it with something that has this many ingredients in it anyway. But that's a personal choice. So you're gonna do 1/2 teaspoon to 1 teaspoon of paprika or smoked paprika, whatever makes you happy. Then you can use either regular yellow mustard, you can use Dijon mustard, you can use spicy mustard, you can use just regular mustard powder, whatever you want. If you're using a prepared mustard, you're gonna probably put about 2 tablespoons worth in. If you're using a dried mustard, you're going to do about 2 teaspoons. So that's a personal choice, whichever you have on hand, either dried or whatever mustard you happen to have in the house will work just fine. So put that in there. Then I have seen several recipes that call for coriander. I happen to like coriander, so I do include it. Absolutely not required. You don't have to have coriander. Oh, and just so you know, Facebook isn't showing me comments, so if you guys are saying hi, sorry, I can't see them. Facebook is not being friendly today. So some coriander. I'm gonna put, what does this my note say? My note says about half a teaspoon, so this is at 1 teaspoon. I'm gonna put in, it's probably about 3/4 or so I'm gonna put in there. All right, then you're gonna want garlic. You can use garlic powder. If you wanna use a regular garlic clove and just dice it up and put it in there, you can do that as well. It doesn't matter. I'm gonna do, how much am I gonna do? I'm gonna do 1 teaspoon. I like garlic. Russ is Italian, he likes garlic, so we're gonna do 1 teaspoon. And then liquid smoke. Now there are definitely some people who don't like liquid smoke. They feel like it's too processed. So if that's you, leave it out. But if you like the flavor of liquid smoke, then put 1/2 teaspoon or so in there. I'm just gonna put a couple dashes. It's really good in the cheese sauce too. One thing I have not seen in recipes, but that I add, is the, brine from jalapenos. Russ really likes spicy, and I like the little bit of bite that it gives it, so I just put some brine in there from jalapenos, plus it makes the nacho cheese really good at the end. So, I don't know, how much was that? 1/4 cup? 1/3 cup? Some. The other thing that I like to add that I don't see a lot on recipes is a little bit of onion powder. Oh, this one's new too. Hold on, maybe I can get it open. Let's see. Without cutting myself is ideal. Come on. Why do they make these things so hard to get into? All right. There we go. So I'm going to put 1 tablespoon or so of onion powder in here as well. And then, sorry, 1 teaspoon. I said tablespoon. That's not what I meant. 1 teaspoon. I'm just going to give it a quick whisk. Make sure it's all nicely blended. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to pour it over the carrot dogs. And if there's not enough to cover them, you can either add more vegetable broth or you can add water. But you definitely want them to be either covered, or if you're the kind of person who's willing to go and turn them, you can do that too. That's an option. A lot of the recipes that I looked at said you should marinate them for a minimum of 4 hours. What I typically do is just put them in the refrigerator and then I leave them in the marinade until we eat them. So, and to cook them, there's several different ways you can heat them up. They're all the way cooked, so they just need to be heated. You can grill them. Just if you're going to grill them, make sure that you're really conscientious when you cook them, that you don't get them too soft, because when you go to grill them, when you turn them, if they're too soft, they fall apart, and that's just heartbreaking. Another option is you can bake them at 450 for about 8 to 10 minutes. That'll give them a nice crispiness on the outside, and they're pretty flavorful. Another option that you can do is you could just take this and stick it like directly in the oven and just bake it in the marinade and everything. That's an option too. You have to bake it a little longer then, and they're not going to get crispy because they're in the liquid. Another way that I've done it is to just put a little frying pan on the stove and just put them on there and just put them in there and roll them around until they're hot, which, that works. It's not going to give you the grill marks or any of that, but it works if that's what you like. And then you put them on whatever bun you like, whatever that works for you, or however you eat your hot dogs. And then with whatever condiments you use, we like sauerkraut and mustard and pickle relish and sometimes ketchup. So whatever you like on your hot dogs, you can eat on these. It is surprising how hot dog like they taste. When the first time I made them, I was like, there is no way. There's no way this is gonna work. It does, and I don't really know why. Oh look, it's gonna be enough to cover them just nicely. So I will pop these in the refrigerator. I'll cover them, obviously, and I'll pop them in the refrigerator and we'll eat them. We might have one this evening. It's kind of late, it's already almost 5, so I don't know. If I do, they won't be all the way marinated to have one tonight, but they're definitely going to be great to eat this week at just along with our lunch salad or something like that. So if you've never made carrot dogs, I would encourage you to give them a try. They are surprisingly good. Even children really, really like them. And hey, if you can sneak a carrot in for your kid to eat and they think it's a hot dog, that's a win. So again, I hope you're having a great Father's Day. Thanks so much for joining me. And go to wholefoodmuscle.com if you want more from me. And as Russ and I always tell you, eat real food, mostly plants. Have a great one. I'll see you later.